Hello and welcome to another training session with computer tutoring. This time we're going to have a look at interactive forms within Adobe InDesign. Now if you want to follow along, you can download the exercise file from the computertutoring.co.uk website, or you just need to type a couple of boxes in, basically first name and last name. It's quite straightforward. So first of all, we're going to create a couple of text fields. And then the idea is we put in the names and we're going to have a submit button. We convert it to PDF, and that's a format that you can distribute using Adobe Acrobat. We're not going to cover the latter part of it, the collating of information and the distribution of the form. It's just the creation of the form and converting it to Adobe PDF. So how do we do it? First of all, if we click on the T tool over here, there we go, and we draw a text box. That's good. Then we just go back to our selection tool and just go over to the text box and just zoom out. What we do is convert this text box to a text field, right click on the box, go down to interactive and down and click on convert to text field. When you click on convert to text field, the buttons and forms panel appears. So we need to give this text field a name. Now there are certain rules with the names. First of all, let me zoom in. It's given a default name, so I'm going to delete that. And I'm going to type in a name. First underscore name. Don't forget to press enter afterwards. Now, as I said, there are certain rules here. Don't press the space bar. You can't have any spaces. And don't start with a number. And don't use any funny characters like symbols, question mark, the hash key. So far, so good. So let me just zoom back out. Now, armed with the selection tool, again, I'm going to go down and hold down the Alt key on the keyboard and drag to create a duplicate. And this time, I want to call this one last name. So just there, so you can see. So last underscore name. Don't forget to press enter. Fine. So now we've got our two text fields here. Last, we need a submit button. I'm just going to use a text field again for that. So I'm just going to draw a text box. Notice that the arrow on my cursor is black. If I hover it, sort of just to line it up underneath the last name, it turns white, showing that it's going to be lined up perfectly with last name. Just going to drag across to create my button here, and I'm going to type in some text, submit. I'm going to centrally align it, go to my move tool. There's a button over here on the right hand side. I'm going to align it vertically. And last but not least, I'm going to just put a color in the background there. So I'm just going to double click on my color options just down here. And then I'll choose a nice blue color, a bit lighter so you can see it. Click on OK. And it's almost ready to go. Last thing I need to do is convert it to a button. So right click on the submit button or text box at the moment, but soon will be a button. We'll go all the way down to interactive and then across to convert to button. Notice the little button in the bottom right hand corner indicating that this is now a button. So I now need to give this a name. So this one, I'm going to call this one submit underscore form and press enter. See, no spaces, no funny characters. I'm now going to add an action to this button. So click on the plus button to the right of actions and go all the way down to and click on submit form. So click on submit form. That's the action it's going to do. But where is it going to be submitted to? If I click in the URL box. Now, if you're quite okay with PHP, ASP or some server-side scripts, you can write a bit of script to handle that code and you can type the URL to that page. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, what we're going to do is type in mail to, M-A-I-L. So move them out of the way so you can see. And then type an email address to which you want to receive the information. And then press enter. Ensure that is your email address. I don't want to get lots of emails at the computer tutoring email address from everybody who's tried this. That's great. So I'm going to zoom back. So almost done. Now, one of the most vital pieces of information you'll need is how to export it. And what you do is you'll go to File and Exports. And then on my desktop, I've created a folder called Interactive PDF. Here's one I've done earlier, my form. I'm going to get rid of my form here. So you can call your form whatever you want. I suggest lower cases and no spaces. But the most important thing is making sure you select Adobe PDF Interactive. If you don't do that, it will just be a normal PDF. We click on the Save button. Yes, to replace it. Click on OK to accept the defaults. And here we have a nice interactive PDF. I can click in first name and type the name in. And then when I click on the Submit button, the form's ready to be sent. If you want to know further information about how to distribute and collate form information in Adobe Acrobat, then please see one of our Adobe Acrobat, probably one of our intermediate courses will suit you fine. If you want any more videos, then please, if you haven't already done so, please see the Computer Tutoring website. Thanks very much for watching.